Hello, my dear friends. Welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting. I wasn't too much active on YouTube for the last few days, but I've been working in behind. I'm putting together a few videos and I hope you will like the coming tutorial, but those videos have to be put together. Right now, I'm working with cereal boxes, with any kind of food boxes. I mean, like boxes from your food, from toothpaste, from perfumes, any kind of boxes I ever saved. And I'm making my own embossing folders. And I have to say, I'm in love with that. It's quite a lot of cutting, die cutting, but it works. It works now when I realized what I did wrong. This was the first one I created and I was too hurry to use it. So I didn't wait too long time to let it dry properly. I use it, I think, half hour after I glued all these pieces together. So I went through to my Sizzix die cutting machine and it did emboss nicely. Look at that. It's my first embossing trying with my first embossing folder made from old envelope, and this is from those boxes, and it's nice. It's not too bad, but this one, I hope you can see that the difference, that this one, it's much more crispy, it's much more beautiful, and it's just because I let it dry over the night properly. I didn't touch it before, and then I tried to emboss the same card with this embossing folder, which was dry properly, and it was much more better. Look at that embossed effect here. And you don't need any kind of thick chipboards or thick boxes, because you do have those plates in your cutting machine, those acrylic plates, which will make that stopper. I'm gonna show you how I started here. I'm gonna probably finish my layering. What I found, that the best amount from my point of view, maybe you wanna make it a little bit more thick or a little bit more thin, it depends, but from my point of view, three layers of normal cereal box, or you know, that perfume box, any kind of box, so three layers of die cut from some kind of these boxes glued together, it gives me exactly thickness I want. I tried that. Where I do have, oh, I do have, I'm gonna show you straight away, just bear with me. I'm gonna put these three together, 1, 2, 3, and I'm gonna let it dry and make sure you've got a nice amount of glue, and use glue which dries hard, if you have any like that PVA glue. But I think PVA glue dries nicely, so PVA glue, I think Mod Podge will be perfect, because Mod Podge dries hard. So any kind of glue which dries hard, not that totally bendable. This put together was, oh my, that was such a terrible work, because those pieces are too small. I did actually try the layers. Here you can see different layers. This is that pushed. And here, I hope you will be able to see. The number 5, it's 2 layers. Number 0 are 3 layers. And that rest are 4 layers of that chipboard. So what I like the most, the number, that 7, it's perfect actually. That 7, it's beautiful. But in those numbers, the number 0, it's bolded and it still shows nicely all those, and it's crispy. So number 3, I mean 3 layers, are from my point of view perfect. The number 7, it's beautiful, it is, but I think it's too thick. So 3 layers, that's what I try here. 2, 3, 4. And I like those three the most. Here I put only 2 layers of those chipboards, and it's nice. It's really good. I like it, but it's not that dimensional. So I will probably add there more. So what I did here, So for cutting those pieces, those die cuts, I used any kind of food boxes, perfume boxes, anything I save from the items I bought for my home. But for making my folders, I chose a little bit something a little bit different, and it's just because of my thinking. I don't like to have my file embossing folder disturbing, so any kind of that colorful print will disturb me when I am crafting. It will just not be the one I wanna see. And also, if I will don't like my embossing folder anymore, I wanna use it in my journals. So for because of that, all those thinking, what I used, it's this type of envelope. You can receive the items from Amazon in this envelope. And I'm using this one because it's nice, strong, and thick enough to make that reverse, this one, to make that reverse embossed effect. And it's perfect because it's already folded. So I took my ruler and knife, and I just cut it on three pieces. First, I cut it those sides because they are overlapped together. So I cut it those two sides here and on that opposite side. And why I came up with this idea, I do love numbers, and there is not too many embossing folders with the right numbers, but I found in my stuff die cuts with numbers with small letters. So I was thinking, why do not do it? And the idea came to me after I had to watch one of my very old video. I think 5 years ago, I shared how you can emboss with stencils and how you can emboss acetate pieces. I will put link for that video down below if you would like to see that. It was quite funny to watch myself. I always feel for you. When I'm reading comments on old videos, I'm thinking, oh, brave you, that you did watch that. Because I felt so badly when I watched my old video. Anyway, I will put the link for that video down below so you can have a look. So when I watched my video with that stenciling, with that embossing with stencils, I was thinking that stencil is not thick. And why do not use my dies or die cuts to create, ouch, my own embossing folder? Everything is falling on me. So I cut that envelope on the pieces. Then I took my embossed three-layered, it was two, but now three-layered die cuts, and I'm gonna make some nice layer. And I'm always already thinking about future use in my journals. And as you can see, you already have that top cover, so it's really easy. And I'm already thinking if I will want to use it later in my journals, it have to have some kind of style already now, so I can actually use it later. So first, I'm gonna glue that label. And I forgot to cut the numbers. So here, I think I'm gonna put those plans. Here I do have the word plans, so I'm gonna give it a try, and I'm gonna glue it inside. So I place my letters on that envelope piece. If you feel or if you see that you have there quite lots of glue around, try to take it off right now, because if it's a glue which dries hard, it can make another bulk which you don't want to see there after embossing. And then let it dry over the night. Or what I did a few minutes ago when I tried those numbers on the other one, I took my heating tool and I heat it like really hardly for a long time, for 10 minutes, I think, to dry out all that glue, to make sure that it's not wet and it's holding well. Here I think the end it's not straight, so I'm gonna oops, and it's dry already. Okay. Yeah, So make your designs. And if you are like me, make the designs you will be able to use in your journals later on. That's why it's good that you can use, you know, scrap material, something you already maybe saved from perfume, from what I said, perfumes, food, anything you saved before, anything, any of those boxes can be very useful. So once you are sure it's totally dry and you can't feel the glue anywhere, I made this one as well, so I give it really long time of that heat, and I hope both are dry. Take your cutting machine and first go with your file folder through to that machine without any cardstock inside. And I'm keeping all layers here on my Big Shot. It's like where I'm using dies. So all those layers, same like I'm using dies, and go through with your folder. So it will flatten that cardboard. It will kind of make it sit totally. So as you can see, I already created my folder. I'm gonna take a card. This is a 250 GSM cardstock, and I'm gonna put there this card. I'm gonna place it right to the end. Put it back. Oh, not this way. Put it back. And make sure it's your folder is dry, because remember, you are working with paper and you don't wanna get any of these to glue together. Oops. And here are my plants. And it looks like this. Plants. And because I have created that wonderful, I'm really wondering how this will look like. So I'm gonna go through to my machine first before, well, without, not before, without any cardstock. I'm gonna take this pearlescent cardstock. I hope you can see that. And I'm gonna place it on my wonderful. See, I already have embossed this. So hopefully, we will see. This is 200 GSM. And I'm gonna give it a try. Okay. And we will see, right? Oh. Have to be careful. I think I maybe didn't. Did I? Oh, good, good. Now I got scared that it's still there glue, but it was just, look how beautiful. And I do have also embossed the pattern of my envelope, and I have to say that I really like that pattern of that envelope. It looks more vintage, so I'm pretty happy about it, because those embossing effects are wonderful. They are. If you wanna see how to emboss with stencils, I'm gonna put the link down below for that very old video. It's kind of like very similar way. In that video, I'm using only toilet paper rolls, because at that time I haven't had this silicone mat. This is silicone mat from Sizzix. I think they still have it, but I think now it's different color. Maybe I didn't actually Google it, but I will have to have a look. Here you can actually see one of my stencils when I use it on stenciling. I can actually show you as well. So for embossing with stencils, I'm gonna use as a base this pink embossing sheet or plate. Then I'm gonna place there this clear one. I'm gonna use this stencil with Coca Poirot. I used that stencil on that last project. I'm editing videos now, so hopefully you will like it. I'm gonna place it upside down because I wanna have those letters erased, embossed through that writing in the right direction, not this way, like I it will be backwards, but I want to have them in right direction. So I'm gonna place my stencil upside down on that cutting sheet. Then I do have here 200 GSM cardstock. I'm gonna place it over my stencil. And I'm gonna take this silicone mat and place it over it. Next will be another cutting plate, and it's kind of fluffy. And I'm gonna give it a try how thick it is. Yeah, it's going too easy, so I know I need to reinforce it a little bit. So I'm gonna take just old box, and I'm gonna place that old box here on the top, and I'm gonna give it a try again to put there a little bit more pressure, but not too much. And very easy, this is really easy. I don't need to twist it too much, so I'm not putting very high pressure. If I will use this cutting plate, it will be just too much. It will give to my cutting machine too much pressure, and I don't wanna go there. So with this, kind of like sandwiching with another papers, I can help to that embossing process, and we will see. And really beautiful embossing effect. So this way you can emboss even with stencils. And when I watched that old video where I used those toilet paper rolls, I kind of was thinking like, it's not too thick, I can make it with my dies if I will stack them together, you know, to make them a little bit more dimensional. I don't know why it took me so long time, but I'm so happy it did came to my mind, and now I know I can emboss even designs I want to see. If they are not on the market, I can create them using my dies. So this is my sharing for today. Make your own embossing folder. Use your dies. Go to have a look what dies you have. Oh, this is empty. I totally forgot I've got these words by Tim Holtz, and I'm planning to use them because I actually like how they can emboss. And all these numbers, that's just my style. So go to have a look what kind of dies you have. Go to have a look what kind of boxes and cereal boxes and, you know, stuff we save you have. And maybe you can create your own designs. And if you do have some stencils you like to have like embossed effect, go for it, because it's not too hard. If you don't have this silicone mat, and this is from Sizzix, so have a look. I think it's called embossing mat, silicone embossing mat, I think it's called that way. So this is from Sizzix. If you don't have this one, use some thicker cardboard and place it under your stencils, or you know, over those papers, like I place those this silicone mat. It will work too. You just need to put there some soft, which will go through with your paper, which will go through to that stencil. So something softer than chipboard, something like cardboard boxes. They are soft enough, or those toilet paper rolls. They are perfect. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you found some inspiration. I will put link for that old video down below for those brave people. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me. Have a beautiful day. Take care about yourself, and I will see you soon. Bye.